Similarly, if I come to this one, this is a constant term, and we will start with psi 3s, which is R30. And R30 is such that now we are having different terms. We are having R over A here and R over A here, and then R over 3A here. So our wave function is R is 0. When our R is equal to 0 here, means we are at the center of this, then at R equal to 0, this term becomes 0. If this becomes 0, then this will become 0 and we are left only with 6 here. And when I come here and R is equal to 0, so this term becomes 0 and we are left only with 6 here. So this divided by this, again we will have a constant term, and here this is R equal to 0 and we will have e to the power 0 and it will become 1. So we are having at R equal to 0 any constant value here, which is that constant. And then as R is increasing, then look here, as R is increasing but R is less than A, R is increasing but it has not yet reached A, then what about this value? This value will be less than 1 because R is less than A here. So if this value is less than 1, it means whatever the multiplication of this with this will be, it will be less than 6. So the result of this value will be positive. If I look here and R is less than A, so this value is less than 1 and 2 by 3 is less than 1, so it is a very small addition with this, but the overall value here will remain as positive. Here when I come for R less than A, then it will be E minus R. So it means it's a decaying function, and I can plot this decaying function like this, that this decaying function will be like this. Let me start not from this value but from this value, for example. Let me start from here in order for the wave function to look accurate. So I will start from, let's say, even start from here. So our wave function is a decaying wave function. I started from here and the wave function is decaying, 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 unless I reach, this is the value which is R equals 2A. Approximately 2A. It is, in reality, it is 1.9A, but consider it R equals 2A. So the decaying at R equal to A, so this will be R equal to A, and we are having the decaying portion. So let's finalize it till here, that R equal to A, in all this range we are having a decaying wave function. Now when R becomes equal to A, what will happen? Here R is equal to A, so these two will cancel. We will have 2 by 3 and 3 will cancel with this, so 2 to 4, so 6 minus 4, it comes out to be 2. So we got 2 value here and here it cancels, so 2 by 3 squared, it will be some addition to 2 point something. So all this value is positive, and here again when R is A, A will cancel and E will be minus 1 over 3, so it's a decaying function. So at r equals a, we are having a decaying value at this point, but positive. When r is greater than a, what will happen? When r is greater than a here, then we will have something divide a will cancel in a value here which will be greater than 1 but less than 2. So again, this will have some contribution, and here if I look, then this is less than 2, so it will make this 4 and divide by 3, and overall this value will remain positive and the decaying will continue unless we reach r greater than a, so we reach r equals 2 times a. When we reach r 2 times a, then we will have here what we will have here. When r is 2a, then aa will cancel, and here I will have 2. This 2 will make this 4. Okay, this 2, let me do it here so that we can see here that when r is equal to 2, we 2 aa will cancel and 2 will remain here. 2 and 2 will make this 4 by 3. So 6 minus 4 by 3 multiplied with 6 here. So what I will have here, that 3 will simplify with this and will make this 2. 2 multiplied with 4, and it will make this thing 6 minus 8. So our overall value has become negative here with these 2. This is 6 minus 8. When r is equal to 2a, then a will cancel and we will have 2 here. 2 and 2 will make this 4, and we will get 4 by 3. And when 4 by 3 is squared, when 4 by 3 is squared, then we will get 16 by 9. So do simplify them. This is 16 by 9. So here what I will get, this is minus 2 plus 16 over 9. Now minus 2 and 16 over 9, if it was, this will become minus 18 if I take 9 as it. Minus 18 plus 16, and it will become non-zero. But as I told you a while ago, that this one is not exactly 2a, this is rather 1.9a. When we do exact calculation, then this value, this point, this line is at 1.9a, and when it is 1.9a, then we are having a proper cancellation. Here is minus 2 differences occurring, so we will have the wave function equal to 0 at r equal approximately 2a, means exactly it is 1.9a. So our wave function becomes 0 here, and is like this. When we go on for other values, then our wave function will become like this, that it goes down like that, and then again it comes up, and then like this decays. So this maximum, let me note here that this second rise is actually coming at 1.7a. to be very exact. At 7.1 a, if I put 7.1 a here for this value, I will again get 0 from this portion, and then it will, the exponential will grow here and it will decay. And if I plot its probability, then its probability will be that for this portion I will have something like this, then the next will be till here, so let me mark this line. So it will be higher probability compared to this one, and when it comes here, this probability will be much much greater than this, and we will have that our particle is having some probability in the first orbit, more in the second, and then it is maximum probable in the third orbit here. Here it is more probable in the second orbit, and here it is in the first orbit. So that is the mathematical means, from the mathematics we can get this much physics. And here if I just plot with this, let me plot here the distribution of the electrons. So it will be somehow in this range, we will have maximum probability in this range. And this range, the probability becoming less, much less, and like this. So the maximum probability we are having in this range. Similarly, here we will have a little probability here, because you see that the probability starts from, means excluding the nucleus, and the probability starts and it becomes maximum here, and then it decays. So here will be some probability, but it will be less. Similarly here, the electrons are, means somehow probable in this region. There is very little probability, and because the probability, this is the first orbit, so at the first orbit it will be maximum, and then as we go on to the second orbit, the probability is even higher here. So we have, the probability is much higher here. We will have some probability beyond this point and below this one, but that probability is much less. And that's why we say that the maximum probability orbits are actually the Bohr orbits. And the same story will be repeated here as well. It will have some probability, which is this one, and then we will have more probability compared to this orbit and this region, in this region, and then very high probability here is this value. I mean, this is not to scale, but just for the sake of plot, we are having maximum probability on the third orbit, because here n is equal to 3 and s orbit, so l is equal to 0. So when, means this is not quite different from the assumptions of Bohr, because he was having very fixed orbit. Now the orbits are not fixed, but it is somehow like this, that we are having less probability here, more probability here, and very high probability here. So means that the electron cannot exist in between these orbits, the Bohr assumption, and it's a fixed orbit, that is not right. Its probability here is maximum, and then the probability decays, and here the probability is the next maximum and then the next maximum. So we plotted the s orbits, the spherically symmetric orbit, and we also discussed this thing that here when we are in the s orbit, the spherically symmetric orbit, it has no dependence on theta and phi, and I will explain it further when we will do the angular momentum, that such orbits, the electron angular momentum is equal to zero because angular momentum is angle dependent. And here we are having an s orbits, whether it is the 1s, 2s, 3s, 4s and so on, we are having no angular dependence, and due to that reason the angular momentum of the electron in the s orbit is zero.